You might know Isaac Newton as a brilliant scientist behind the laws of motion and gravity, but did you know he was once a curious young boy doing all sorts of experiments? We have teamed up with the National Trust for its Summers of Discovery. This school holiday you can visit Isaac Newton's childhood home and try some coolest science experiments hands-on right there. Learn more by clicking the link in the description below, but first, watch the video till the end to see how to build the paint pendulum right at your home. We're starting by poking two holes at the top of the rim opposite each other. Then I grabbed a thread and cut a small piece of about 50 centimeters to make a little handle for our paper cup. To make this project easier, you can use just one piece of thread to connect paper cup to the top bar, but I want to make sure that it is quite easy to replace the cup. If I need to wash it, I can take it off and put it back again. So I decided to make it a bit more complicated, and I will show you how later on in the video. So after we finished our paper cup, we need to poke a hole at the bottom. Later the paint will be pouring out of this hole. That's why for now we are covering the hole with the sellotape. Moving on to the next step, we need to build two towers. You can use lots of books or perhaps chairs, but I found some empty cardboard boxes that I will be using, so I just need to add some extra weight to the bottom of the box to make sure that each tower is very stable. This experiment can potentially be very messy, so the first thing first, we need to cover our table with tablecloth, and then we are putting our towers. Wrapping paper tube goes on top. I have tied the thread to the tube, and here is what I mentioned before, you can just add your cup. But I'm just doing the extra step. So I'm just measuring my cup and then adding a paper clip. This paper clip will work as a hook, so I need to open it up and trim the excess. I used sticky tape to secure wrapping paper tube in place so it doesn't move. So now it's time for us to make our special paint. I mixed about one part of paint to one part of water. But this is not one formula that fits everyone. You have to find the mixture that works for you. So, but general suggestion, it should be quite liquidy. Everything is ready for us to start the experiment. I put a piece of paper, connected to my cup, and put some paint. I've tested my pendulum launching skills and I was quite good at that, so it was time to peel off sticky tape. But my paint was too thick and it wouldn't go through the hole at the bottom of the cup, so I needed to add extra water to the paint and try one more time. And a success! It really worked. My pendulum skills weren't that great, so after drawing the line, I pushed it a bit to the side and started creating those beautiful patterns. Very soon I realized that it's easier to use just a finger to cover the hole at the bottom of the cup while pouring the paint, rather than using sticky tape that wouldn't work because the cup is wet after the first try anyway. When the setup was completed and tested, I needed to find ways to experiment with my swinging techniques and colors, and the first idea I came up with was to use two different colors. So I was painting with red color, and then I poured some blue paint into the same cup and pushed it in a different direction, and that created this beautiful butterfly effect. I can't even call that, because it does look like a butterfly, doesn't it? Then it was time to invite my son to try this painting technique. So first he tested how the cup moves around, so he was just playing a bit with a push, and then he asked for two different colors to be poured in the same cup, and then he started drawing. And I should say that the way he pushed the cup and the colors he chose made it into the most beautiful unique pattern we had created on that day. There was one more thing I wanted to test, to see how the length of the string influenced the patterns. So I tied up a knot in the middle of the string, just to make it shorter basically. Learning from my son, I decided to use two colors of paint in the same cup and just give it a go and see what different patterns I'm gonna have. Isn't it amazing how science and art come together? I would love for you to continue experimenting. Just visit the link in the description for more information. Whether you want to try experiments at home or visit Woolthorp Manor to see them in action, there is so much more to discover. Join us in celebrating the wonders of science and let your curiosity lead the way. When it was time to clean after all the experiments we have done, I decided to give it another go and used a broom and two chairs, and it turned out to be quite easy setup, and it created the patterns as beautiful.